Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and welcome to Station 21. Now, we are going to be looking at a posterior view of the thigh region, but we're going to look a little superiorly first and focus on the muscles in the gluteal region. So these are the glutes. There are going to be three, and they will kind of go from superficial to deep and from largest to smallest. So starting with the gluteus maximus, which you can see is going to be, I'm going to outline it right here. And you see that I didn't include this muscle up here, which is actually a little bit of the gluteus medius. So you can see just a little bit superior to the gluteus maximus of the gluteus medius. Otherwise, the gluteus maximus completely occludes or covers up the gluteus medius and certainly the gluteus minimus. So this is the gluteus maximus. It is kind of the largest muscle, not the longest, but the largest muscle of the body. It's going to have attachments on the posterior ilium and the sacrum and the coccyx, and the majority of its fibers will insert on the IT band or IT tract, with some that are going to insert directly onto the posterior or posterior lateral femur region. So that's the gluteus maximus. It's quite obvious, I think, in terms of that. If you can clearly see a muscle inserting into the IT band and being very superficial, you are likely looking at the gluteus maximus. Now, to look at the gluteus medius, obviously you're going to have to reflect the gluteus maximus, other than being able to see that small portion up here. And so now you are seeing the gluteus medius here a little bit more laterally. It is going to be on the same plane as the piriformis muscle that we talked about in association with the pelvic muscles. But recall that that piriformis is going to exit the pelvic girdle region and actually will insert on the greater trochanter, which is right in this region, which you can see the gluteus medius is also inserting or having its distal attachment on that greater trochanter. So these two are on the same plane. I know this is the piriformis because I can see the exit of all that neurovasculature from there, including the sciatic nerve. So that helps me get my bearings in terms of where I'm at. And in order to see the gluteus minimus, which we are looking at right here, and you can see the tendon extending down to the greater trochanter as well. The gluteus minimus is it's directly on the bone, so you have to get quite deep in order to see that. And you can see this is piriformis, which has not been removed, but it's on a slightly more superficial plane than the gluteus minimus. And what you're seeing here, all this neurovasculature that is running kind of right on top of the gluteus minimus, is that superior gluteal neurovasculature, which will supply both the gluteus medius and the minimus, and it is coming superior to the piriformis, whereas the large sciatic nerve and the inferior gluteal neurovasculature and other things will be moving or traversing inferior to the piriformis. So in order to see the gluteus minimus, you have to, of course, reflect the gluteus maximus, and you also have to reflect the gluteus medius in order to be able to see that. And you can see a bit of where this was cut here. So this muscle is going to be gluteus minimus, but then you can see a little bit thicker muscle here, and that's where that gluteus medius has been cut in order to see the deeper gluteus minimus. Okay, excellent. So those are the three large gluteal muscles. Again, they go from superficial to deep and from largest to smallest in order of their organization. So really a lot of reflection has to be done in order to be able to see the full complex. Okay, excellent. Thank you for visiting me at this station. We will move to the hamstring muscles at the next station. Thanks for your time.